We are hot. We are live here in Chatter, Southwest Florida. I'm Anthony. I'm glad to be back here in sunny Southwest Florida. Not really. I kind of miss the cold weather up there. So we're live on Chatter, so you know. We're going to have the edited version come on out. Christian Young is behind the camera right over here. He'll be taking care of that, and we'll put all of their links and all the good stuff somewhere. Probably above you, I think it starts, right?
I like it.
Our social posts. So yeah. It'll be right up here. We're going to ask questions of Danny. We want to get to know you. We're going to talk a little bit about business.
Yeah.
But everyone knows what Danny does already. He's got it on the shirt. I don't know what that G is. We're going to dig into that. Danny, let's start by sharing what you do, your business. We know we had your wife here.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't have you. You chickened out.
Well, you had the best part.
We lassoed him. We did. No, she was, you know, quickly, she inspired. I mean, she's back here behind the camera. I didn't expect that to come out of her. I just didn't expect it because there's perceptions of people, and until you sit and meet them and you actually speak with them, just very well spoken.
Yeah.
The her etiquette behind it, the way that she interacted and shared with her other business folks, I guess you'd call them.
Our teammates, team members.
You're right. There you go. It was kind of shocking, like a bit, because there's a lot of people in town, as we were saying, that have the perception of it, and some people you're very humble, so. It was definitely nice to have that come out and see, and hopefully more people will have her on shows. ABC 7, Fox 4, Wink News. So all right,
ESPN,
Danny.
Let's go.
ESPN. All right, let's talk about you, because I want to know all about Danny Nix.
Well, born and raised on a farm, as well as doing mobile homework when I was younger. Athens, Georgia.
Farm, like pigs.
Like, we had 5 brooder houses, which is for chickens. So you're raising chickens after they've hatched, before they go
just
to
eggs, or you actually eating them.
Well, no, they've already hatched, so okay. they're bringing them out there. We feed them and raise them so that you can and eat them.
Chicken.
Yes.
Not the eggs or both.
No, not the eggs. Uh-huh. I cleaned those houses when I was younger.
Okay. All right.
Was brought up in a great home, good mom and dad. My right arm was always my sister, so I was very, very blessed to have her in
my
life.
Older?
She's older. 4 years, 7 months, 21 days. I can get to the hours and minutes.
And you said you're fortunate to have had her, or
she? To have had her.
She's passed.
No, she's still here.
Oh, she's still here. You're saying,
but we live so far away. I'm sorry.
No, you're just saying, okay. To have her, okay.
Yes.
She lives far away.
She's just absolutely amazing. But I think the best part that I like to talk about is not the accomplishments in life, but my faith. I'm so blessed mm-hmm. to have found God. A lot of that I give my wife bringing me back, because I was the partier and loved to have a lot of fun.
Yep. Yep.
But my faith is probably the biggest thing that I want people to know about me.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly is the love that I have for my wife and my 2 girls. I mean, they're my everything.
Yeah.
Sometimes I get a little misty thinking about what they really mean to me.
Yeah.
And the blessings of having them in my life that I do not deserve.
Mm-hmm.
Try to be a good friend. And when those things are kind of there, I do commercial real estate for Nix uh-huh. Associates. And
it all comes together. You mentioned your faith and that you want that to be sort of a leader. So when you think of Danny, that you think of faith first.
Mm-hmm.
When did that click for you to say, all right, I'm not afraid to put that out there? Because I got to tell you, that's where I'm at. I'm Christian. I'm a baby with my faith, and I'm going through it to where I want to just scream it out, like my Bible. I just got a brand new Bible.
Yeah.
I didn't post that I got a Bible and let all my friends know that I fell asleep with it on me. I told you that prior.
Yeah.
So when is it a good time to just scream from the rooftops that, hey, I am this, my faith, I'm leading with that, and my life has changed to where I'm going down that path? Like, when did that click for you?
I guess probably 37, maybe. 37, I'm 40 now. But here's what I had to come to grips with. Love Jesus.
Because you can lose business just by that, too. Well, does that affect you? Or you could lose friends?
I don't care about that.
That's what I want to hear.
And maybe I should, but maybe. I don't. Because yeah. I would rather, as a movie that I absolutely love, God's Not Dead 2, and it says, I'd rather face the world with God on my side
mm-hmm.
than try to face God with the world on my side.
So
here's what I'll tell you. For me, it was coming up with this understanding that I'm still young in my faith, and I'm not perfect. I'm one of the most imperfect, dysfunctional people you will ever meet.
We gotta hang out more.
I just am. I'm not perfect. Sin comes into my life. I have to repent daily. I have to die daily to that.
Right.
But, you know, I was so fearful that I am not, I'm going to turn people away from God because of my actions.
Right.
That I still probably do.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? That's who I am. I just want people to know about Jesus. He'll do the work.
Right.
I don't need to do the work.
Have you noticed that?
Yeah.
Like the blessings that just come without, it's like, you didn't expect it.
Oh, man.
It's not always, as we spoke about, you know, when your wife was on, it's not the success of the money or the business. It's just meeting people and connecting, mm-hmm. and the blessings that just come around. Like, you think you're in like a dark place or something is really going bad. And in reality, that was just a stepping stone to get you here. It toughened you up. It's very bizarre, I guess you'd say. It is,
but man, I just want to reiterate, I am not perfect. I think that's one thing that scares a lot of people too, is when you talk about your faith, people come in and they think, oh, I've got to be perfect. And people are going to judge me.
They're going to judge, right.
And, you know, I welcome that because I'll be the first one to tell them, hey, I drink. You may see that as a sin. End result is I still love God. That's my it's a personal relationship that I have that gets me through every day.
Right.
And it makes me love my wife more every day.
Mm-hmm.
Because I just don't deserve her.
Gratitude.
Yeah.
Well, you're right the same way. She's very humble. She's very humble. We're going to start with a few questions about you. Can we put a picture up here? There was one that I saw on social media.
Is it
going to
be University of Georgia? Go Dawgs?
It's not, because I don't even want to talk about that right
can
now.
Can I share my picture?
Yes, go ahead. While Christian's working on whatever he's working on back here, are you on fisheye? Or are you zooming in on him? How's the? How are we looking here? There was another picture. Did you happen to get the other picture?
No, it was someone else.
It was the other one. All right. We won't even talk about that right now.
I don't know if anybody can see it, but I just want y'all to see Sony Michelle talking about that SEC championship. Go Dawgs!
All right, we're gonna cut right now. You even got the shirt on.
Hey.
Their fight song, Glory, Glory, right?
Glory, Glory to old Georgia.
We should have had that going. We should have had that. I saw on social media, what's up with the plane? You an adrenaline junkie?
Yeah, raced motorcycles for a while when I was younger.
I knew it. See? I wrote that in my notes back here. I was like, adrenaline junkie, ?
I love it. There's
So you're out there just seeing if you want to get your license, or are you actually going through the process of getting
We're working through the process to see if it makes sense or not. You know, as me and Carla have talked about, for not only investment opportunities, but her mother, who we absolutely adore, lives in Chattanooga, and her dad. And then my parents live in Athens. It's 11 to 13-hour rides to where we can sit back and 4-hour plane ride and really enjoy our weekends with our family, because that's
And getting a private plane is not as expensive as a lot of people think.
Oh, you rent it.
Yeah.
Yeah, you
it's
don't
It's timeshare sort of, right?
Yeah, you just rent it. Save the money.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. So that's kind of the real purpose behind that. Yeah. I was actually wondering about that. Another thing that I'm curious about. What is Seamus McFamous?
What is that
all about? What is
Seamus McFamous? My alter ego.
Tell me, who can Seamus come out, or is Seamus not going to come out today?
Seamus does not have his kilt today.
Does not. All right.
I go to Deep Creek Community Church, and we were doing a Christmas special last year, and me and Chris Clow did a rap for Christmas, Wrap It Up.
Gotcha.
And I rocked the kilt, let me go ahead and tell you.
See, I had that here, but I didn't know what it actually was. So that's an
no
ego
pictures
of yours.
Though, right?
No pictures. No pictures, but Seamus McFamous. So it's, okay, so you guys were doing a rap, you dressed in a kilt?
Yes.
Why didn't you wear that today? Boxers below, though. You got to put some.
You got to rock the kilt right.
You got to. Camera be panning down. Oh, we can't do that. So, all right. So, I'm going to have to find some pictures. I'm going to have to find some pictures and get that out there on social media.
No, I think we're good.
You're good?
Yeah,
sure?
I don't know that Seamus will ever come back.
Oh, okay. Another question that just has my mind spinning. Why does everyone in your office have accents? It's kind of a weird accent. Yours is coming out weird. Your wife's got one.
Well, I mean.
Sort of a, I don't know what that
twangy.
Is.
Twangy? We like to tell people, we may talk slow, but we think pretty fast.
Your wife does, yeah. Yes. She's good. She should become a lawyer. Look, she's shaking her head now. I, I would not want to challenge her. Looks like we're breaking a commercial in just a few minutes. We got about a second or two. So everyone in your office practically they have accents.
Well, depending on we have a lot of people Chicago, you know, all over the place. Yeah. So, but we got some Southern twang in the office.
Beverly, for sure.
Yes.
Yeah, that's yourself. I didn't know. I've heard you talk a couple of times. I didn't know how deep that accent is.
Yes, sir.
That accent is really deep. All right, Danny, we're going to break the commercial. We're back in about 30 seconds. Thanks for joining us here on Chatter Southwest Florida. We'll see you in 30 seconds. Okay, we're still live.
Okay.
I'm the live feed.
Seamus McFamous.
What in the world? Oh, I thought that was not coming out.
I pulled that one out. All right, so we got a couple more. So I'll go through a couple more questions with you. And, yeah.
Yeah, at our church, though, that was...
How was our queue? We can start with that.
No.
All right, we're back here on Chatter Southwest Florida with Danny Nix, N-I-X. What's up with the name, Nix? Not N-I-C-K-S. Did you happen to change your last name?
No.
Nix is it. Nix. I actually want that last name.
I mean, just stop.
That's a cool last name.
Just stop. No.
Just Nix. Just
come here and stop. We got you.
Just Nix.
That's right.
All right, let's talk. You were going to speak something about your church.
Well, I was just going to say when you were asking about Seamus McFamous, that was a big production that was done that we kind of mimicked.
Gotcha.
So that's how the name actually came.
Where can I see
it?
It's got to be recorded somewhere.
We can get that to you.
I got to see it.
Yeah, we can get that. I think it's on the archives for our church.
I got to get a couple stills out of that. All right, let's get into you a little bit more here. Mm-hmm. Heard you just turned 40 a couple months back.
I did.
Big 4-0. Welcome to the 4-0 club.
I love it.
And we were talking about dropping some weight and working out and all that good stuff. Mm-hmm. Yeah, 40, you got to. You got to.
Yeah, but I'm tired of dropping hair.
Right. It's like, hey, I'm losing weight, but what's actually being lost here?
I mean, it stays here. But it's leaving here.
It is. It's going back here. It's like out of my shoulders. Right? Like, kind of goes up. And it,
yeah.
It's like, all right. So you turned 40, and I heard you jumped on some motorcycles and you rode out west.
Man.
Tell me about that trip.
What an absolutely amazing time. Me and two of my buddies just got on our bikes. My wife was okay with me leaving for this big trip. We rode from here through Alabama, Louisiana, Mississippi, went to Texas, New Mexico, Utah, Colorado, rode Pikes Peak, Idaho, Montana,
really good country.
Wyoming, and then we finished in South Dakota on my 40th birthday.
Nice.
And my wife showed up with John Davidson and his wife. And just had an absolutely amazing time.
In South Dakota.
It was, but I'll tell you the best part was the ride out there because it was such a reflection time.
So you biked the whole time?
Yeah, we've got Harleys. Me and, I don't know if you know Bill Holly or not with Fawcett, and
no.
Brad Lipness, we rode out together.
Well, were you a little bit, I mean.
No, mine's a little different. I got a Harley CVO.
I'm just worried about your prostate. I mean,
I got a Tempur-Pedic seat that's heated.
Not to get too personal, but that's a couple of days on that was just, yeah.
I did not think that you were going to talk about my prostate today.
Well, I was thinking on the Harley. I thought maybe like you guys pulled them and stopped at certain areas. You know, you rode in a
not every 150 miles, but no, we rode them out there, man.
Really?
Like I said, we got Tempur-Pedic seats.
Yeah,
it's not.
I feel like make them different now.
Well, anyway. Some. But mine's on the upper end of what you're going to buy.
So you ended up at South Dakota, and you rode back home, or did you transport them back?
No, we flew back because we would not miss our daughter's first days of school.
How'd you get the Harley back?
Oh, we had a trailer back.
Oh, trailer back. Okay.
Yeah.
You know, it's beautiful to go through the country. I was maybe in my mid-20s, and I literally took a map, did one of the old dart things, threw it at it, and it landed right in Nebraska. A couple weeks later, I flew out to Lincoln, Nebraska, all by myself. I was out there for maybe 3 or 4 days. Beautiful. Lincoln, Nebraska is amazing. It's just part of the country that, you know, you never expect to see. Especially, you know, South Dakota. Like, who would think of South Dakota? But it's beautiful out there, huh?
Oh, well, you know, you got Mount Rushmore.
Yeah.
You got Needles Highway. I mean,
most people don't even think about that, though.
Beautiful.
They don't
the
think
Badlands.
Yeah, yeah.
So I got Jason Aldean blaring as I'm riding down the Badlands with my wife just enjoying life.
Love it.
Just doesn't get any better.
Well, we got a couple other questions for you. One person I know when you were on the show, and I know we had someone on the show. We had this is episode 21, right? 21 or so. So we had a couple of guests on the show. One of them was Kevin Graham.
Mm-hmm.
You guys are friends.
Yeah.
Whatever. And I know we spoke briefly. I'm just curious. Not that it's just us in the room. No one else is watching. After this replay, the couple thousand might see it. But what is your opinion about the guy?
I like him.
Because I didn't like him here in the show.
Well, I mean, that's personal.
Straight up, I didn't like him. But what is your take on him?
I've had no issues with Kevin. We enjoy ourselves.
Well, look.
Kevin, hey, bud.
How are you, man?
See?
We want to bring Kevin back on the show with Danny.
Hey, buddy. Good to see you. Love that shirt.
Thank you, man. What's up? You know what? I have a picture of?
Good to see you.
Seamus McFamous.
Yes, you do.
No.
Yeah, well, it's
he
right
does
there.
Go to church with me.
It's right there on your Facebook page, though.
Oh.
It is. See?
Where are you in that picture?
This is him right here.
For the folks watching here on Chatter, what we're going to do is we're going to get that onto our edited version. We're going to paste that right in on top. So we're going to get this shot.
Yeah.
This gentleman here was the one who wanted to shared me about that. He just got that to me this morning.
We are really good friends, aren't we? Thanks a lot, bud.
Yeah, no problem.
But I was just kidding about
Chris,
not liking him. No.
Oh,
Chris,
I know.
You want this? You want to text it? I'll text it to you.
And we will get that on the show.
Here,
so don't worry about
you
like providing us anything.
I don't think you want to shout out your cell number.
But Kevin and I, we
TV.
Coordinated a bit. I was like, you know, I have to come on the show. I'm kidding. I'd be like, but he was one of the guys when he sat here. We connected well. He brought out his faith, which I didn't know. And he was another kind of a stepping stone in my life. You're kind of bringing that back out to me. And I know we talked briefly about it, of being able to speak about it and being able to get that out without feeling someone's going to not want to work with us, you know, because of that, or not want to be my friend.
Mm-hmm.
Or, you know,
I like what you said, though. You know, I'd rather face the world with him on my side than face him with the world on my side.
I do want to say.
I definitely would not. I wouldn't want that.
Not to get weird right now, but you smell really good.
Thank you.
The gentlemen are bonding. If we can just keep the frame on.
Hold on.
As they say in Georgia, you smell purdy.
Purdy, man.
So, yeah, but I wanted to bring Kevin kind of a little surprise on, like,
fun.
The show. And
I love it.
It's something that's
fun.
Like
this guy.
Yeah. Dan is
good. Yeah, he said yes. Yeah, and I want to bring him. And I do want you to come on again on the show, because I kind of want to have an episode about faith.
Okay.
And I want to talk about that, because it seems like everyone who I'm having on is a Christian or is, mm-hmm. is deep in their faith somehow, which I never knew. And
you know what's
and we said that when you came on. I didn't know that. I mean, I kind of did, but I didn't. You know, you do what you don't.
I would say also one of the things that's true about a lot of Christian men, God, we owe it to our women.
Oh, amen, brother.
Do we do?
Once you humble yourself and you stop being a man, well, I shouldn't say that.
Yeah.
The ego of like the man, and then that comes off a bit during that time, and you think about how much they actually do.
Oh, yeah.
Like for us and
and how much they bring you back to reality. If they don't, they kind of smack you back to reality.
I've had my wife on too. I'm going to have her on. I'm going to blow some faces off with some of the shows that we're going to have and talk about just our journey, our belief in the faith. My faith is a little stronger than hers at this point, but up there at Mission, it's called Mission Cashers. 9 o'clock in the morning, they have a gathering where they go in the hallway, and the CEO comes down and she has them pray.
Nice.
They all talk. This is at a public place, you know, of like employment. But it's different. So her faith is starting to grow, you know, a bit with it. Just hearing me and.
So I'm going to ask you a question.
Oh.
That
there you go. Put him on this
one. I can go ahead and tell you, I'm going to lose my man card with people who are watching this when I answer it, because I'm going to answer it.
Okay.
What is one of your favorite things to do with your wife at Christmas time? Because you wanted to learn about me, I'm going to tell you a lot.
All right, one of the favorite things to do with my wife at Christmas time, like on Christmas Day or around the holidays?
Just around the holidays.
I have to say, okay, this is the honest truth, so she will watch this. Show her off.
High five,
and the thing is, the thing is, she doesn't like the social part of it. Again, I'll be having her on the show, and she'll explain something that happened to her, which is bad. I mean, she was harassed and stalked, and some severe things that happened to her because of that. So show her off more. It's like she's allowing me to take more pictures. She's live streaming more. She's getting her comfort level back with it. But I want to kind of bring her out more and show what she's done for me. And but we do that personally. Like my family and my friends will come over, and I love showing. Show her off. Like I just want to spend the time with her. And
you know, and some people would say that's a physical thing, and they don't get.
No,
that's a relationship.
You got to see her
right.
Heart.
You are
proud of her heart. Like what she does for the family.
Right.
And, oh no,
it's not arm candy. That's what people don't get.
No, it's not
it's
that. She's beautiful to me.
An amazing woman.
Yes. And that's it can be 6 o'clock in the morning. We're having coffee, and she just woke up, and she looks beautiful.
Amen.
But it's just I can see her. I can see her soul. I can see who she is, and that's what I want to show off. So that's what I want to share.
Right, mine's gonna be weak when I answer. Yeah, but what's yours?
I know. I think I can guess what yours is.
No, but I want to know yours.
You know, there's I got to tell you, there's two things that I like, and one of them I'm gonna steal your answer because I think you like shopping with your wife.
No.
No. Okay. No. I actually like to go shopping.
I
with
like
Kim.
Shopping.
You know, we do. You know, I like to see the fun that she's having, and
yeah.
especially when she's shopping for somebody else, she's mm-hmm. got a joy to her. And the other thing, honestly, I love when we finally shut down for 10 minutes and have a glass of wine on the couch and watch Christmas movies.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's, you know,
that
it's very hard to shut
what?
Down.
That I haven't done yet, but now in Highlands I'm able to. The Christmas movies are going to come out.
Yeah.
So mine is.
Mm-hmm. Not that your wife's here. Go ahead.
Yeah. She can hear.
I know what he's going
to
say.
I absolutely love to wake up early in the morning or right before we go to bed, snuggle, and watch Hallmark.
The Hallmark Channel.
I love to watch the Hallmark Christmas movies. So I know I'm losing my man
card.
Not
to
y'all me. Take it. I don't care. Like Hallmark.
This young man back here, he's giggling. You're probably doing that with your girlfriend. He's getting serious with his girlfriend.
It doesn't, man. He's a Jets fan.
He's a Jets
fan. They don't. They're
the Hallmark. Yeah.
What does that mean?
Channel.
He didn't have one.
Well, was that what you were thinking? Just sitting back and cuddling and watching a good movie. My mom watches that. Over and over. She's digging into that, yeah.
You know,
see,
the
we
Christmas
watched
Train
Lampoon's
or
Vacation
Christmas.
Last
good.
Night. And
I see, I didn't
and
know
Elf.
Anything that's like he's familiar. Well, you got this show coming up Friday at 9.
I'm just saying, The Christmas Train and Miss Christmas are two pretty good ones.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to dig into that. All right, Danny, let me ask you. We're going to, before I'm going to ask you a question, I got one kind of a deep family question that I want to ask you. I don't know any answers to it. Just came out of my head here. But we're going to break to a quick commercial break. We'll be back in about 15, 20 seconds. Thanks for joining us here on Chatter, Southwest Florida.
We're
still
live.
This is
fun. Yeah. I'm glad you're here.
Do you realize it's like been almost 25 minutes, 30 minutes?
Yeah.
That's how fast.
I can do this for days.
Show. We watched Elf and Lampoon's Vacation last night.
I've been warned. They were like, control it.
That's great.
We have a party at our house to watch that with the high school kids.
They were like, control the conversation.
That's great.
Yeah, this just goes by so fast that, you know, we're being counted in. All right, we're back on Chatter with Danny Nix. Kevin Graham snuck in from the back door over there. Got a question for you. I like to ask everyone this. It's not the one about would you spend money on the last big purchase, but I'm trying to find out the rocks. Like, what is a foundation of like your life? One thing that inspired you throughout your life. A foundation, a person, an occurrence. Something was a foundation, and you can't say your wife. Something could be growing up when you were a teenager.
My brother-in-law, Byron Bates.
Your brother-in-law?
Blue chip prospect in football, had scholarships, well, in football and baseball. Boston Red Sox were drafting him, which is the reason why I'm a Red Sox fan.
You're a Red Sox?
Yeah. I know it's weird being from Georgia.
No one told me that.
And yeah. I like the Braves, too.
I'm a Yankee fan, Danny.
Well, you have more championships than us. It's okay.
26, I know.
He does know it doesn't.
So here's what I'll tell you. I'm not that into baseball.
All right,
I like my Stone Crabs because we have a sign in right field.
I did say that.
But I am.
Okay, so you're saying so your brother-in-law. So how did that? How did he become it?
He's a man of true integrity and character. He's a man that puts his family before anything else. Now he didn't always do that, but he showed me that it's okay to fall. Just as long as you got love in your heart and you really know where your true focus is,
right.
Everything else works out.
So what happened? What happened to him? What is his story? He was getting recruited and then
did he get recruited? He had messed up his shoulder, but he got my sister pregnant in high school, and had an opportunity to leave. And he said, "You know what? I'm going to be a dad. I'm going to be a husband. I just love her."
Mm-hmm.
And I think they're the all-American story. They have done very well for themselves.
They're still together, I take it.
Neither one of them have a college degree, which, hey, I got mine, sis. You can still go back and get yours. But they have just amassed an amazing business. They have four kids that are, once again, impeccable, stellar in community. One of them, Dawson Bates. I'll give a shout-out to my nephew, who I love, that has just signed a full wrestling and academic scholarship, which they generally only give out partial scholarships.
I was going to say, because if he gets injured, he gets something to fall back to.
Full for 5 years. picks his own weight class.
Where at?
To App State, Appalachian State.
Yeah.
So he'll be in Boone.
That's over in Boone.
Yes.
That's by Banner Elks.
So go over and see Dawson Bates. That kid is a beast on the map.
Sugar Mountain over there.
Sugar and Beach Mountain, yeah.
I'm really familiar with that, yeah.
But Byron's just, he's been a rock for me for a lot of my life. We don't talk as much as we used to because we're both really busy. But it's that great relationship.
You always kind of recall that.
That I can go back to. And I can call him anytime. Mm-hmm. And my dad passed away last year, and it's been, it's still really tough for me. But I wear his dog tags every day.
There you go.
But Byron's always been that father figure that I can call, and he can help me out.
Yeah. And, that's a bummer to hear about your dad. My grandma, she just passed. Yeah, it's kind of a shocker. I'm getting to that age where my grandparents are passing. Mm-hmm. My parents are still, they're both still alive, but I don't want to say it, but you know, I mean, it is a matter of a decade,
well,
potentially.
Well, you know, you had a tough year and a half there. You lost, a few.
We did, and I'll tell you, another man that had a ton of influence on my life, and I didn't know him long, was Gene Swofford. It was Carla's dad who passed away, but he's, you know, my dad wasn't a hunter, and when I talk about working on farms, I mean, that was my uncle's farm that I was on working.
Can't believe you killed those poor chickens.
That ain't the only thing we do.
But,
let me go ahead and say, it was legal and gameful. So, deer, turkey, those things, when I bring that up. Yeah. But
I had chicken for dinner. What's wrong with killing the chickens?
I mean, he killed them right there on the spot. Well, so you killed your own?
No.
Oh, okay. Nice.
Well, the grocery store.
The Publix.
You're not going to eat your feed. You got to do what you got to do.
I know it. But death is definitely, you know, we're kind of all getting to like that age. How old are you again? 40?
I'm 50.
You're 50?
Yeah. That's right.
So y'all got us by a couple.
Yeah, I'm not getting
by
old.
A couple. But it's just kind of, you know, you get to that part of life where it does start to happen.
I heard you guys in here talking about, you know, the going downhill, and I'm thinking, man, I'm at the bottom of the hill then.
No, no. No, you're on the uptick.
Oh, okay.
You're in great shape. You have a lot going for you. You know what? Darn it.
Besides that smell party?
Darn it. People like you.
He told me some things about you. All right, Danny, we're going to head to the lightning round. I'm going to put you on the hot seat. I'm going to ask you four words.
Cyclical.
That's one of them. Did you look at the... No, he didn't. Look, Christian. Christian's like, wait a second. All right, I'm going to put you on the hot seat here. First thing that comes to mind, and don't sit on it. Give yourself just... All right? So I'm looking around. Your head over here. First word. Ready? I think I know what your answer's going to be. Red.
Georgia.
First thing that came to mind was Georgia, red. I thought he would say Knicks. I thought he would say your business.
It's my favorite.
I thought
color.
He said Sox. You know?
Look,
Georgia
Sox.
Georgia's been a factor in my life since I was very, very young. When my parents went through their divorce, it was the constant in my life.
I think if you say blue, I'd be a Yankee. He's like, yeah, Yankees have been a pillar.
So that's why.
Yeah. All right, number two, forbidden.
Fruit.
No apples for you.
Well, I mean, there's a saying.
It's just cool to hear what people think. Because you're probably thinking of something different.
Nah, that's cool.
You can chime in, too.
That's what came up. I was thinking that. I thought of Seminoles, so, you know.
Seminoles.
Yeah. They're garnet.
Yeah, well, you know. That's as close I could get.
A little
more
garnet. Their view is a little bit different. Yeah. All right, number three, confession. Zaxby's. Confession.
I need it all the time.
Zaxby's? What?
I'm hungry.
Oh,
what is confession?
Well, he's confessing that he wants
to go. I'm confessing that I've lost a lot of weight, but I have to eat that food.
Don't do it. Don't eat that food. They put that oil.
Don't you ever say that again.
No,
Zaxby's is amazing.
No fast food. Highlands, there's no fast food places. Not one single fast food. Everything is natural.
I feel like God may be saying, eat Zaxby's.
I don't want any fast food.
I prayed
look
about
at that
it
sign over there. That's Nathan's famous hot dog.
I got my wife over there going, please don't let him talk anymore.
All right, and the last question for the whole show here, festive.
Christmas.
Festive.
I thought holidays.
Holidays.
Yeah, Thanksgiving, right. Christmas, they, you know, put it all
festive.
Together. Yeah.
It is. I thought some people are going to say lights, trees, huh? Santa. All right, well, that is it. Thank you so much, Danny. It was a pleasure
having you, buddy.
Kevin.
Hey,
man,
thanks
it's a pleasure
for letting me
having
join.
You. Come on well, back to the show. And thanks for joining us here. Got Danny Nix, Kevin Graham snuck in on the show here, but this is Danny Nix's
Danny
Hour.
Nix show.
Stay tuned for the Nix's Hour coming to you every 2 weeks, probably right here on Chatter Southwest
thanks
Florida.
Thanks for watching.
I have a feeling Danny's going to get his own show very soon. Thanks for watching Chatter Southwest
Can
Florida.
Can he come in as Seamus?
We'll have the edited version coming up. All the links will be up above here. This is the live version, so if we messed up, we said something that we don't mean, don't hold it against us. But thank you for joining us tomorrow. We got two awesome gentlemen coming on, Tom Parker, Sean McLaughlin.
Love those guys.
And Amy Steer is going to be on Thursday playing the saxophone, so we got some cool shows coming up. And I'll be back in January. for more shows as well. So tune in, say hi, click their links. We'll put your link up there and all that good stuff. And
I
last
love,
word.
Love to say this. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, because we'll be playing through all Amen. Through the holidays. Merry Christmas. Christmas to everyone at home. We'll see you on the flippity flip, Georgia side.
Go Dawgs.
Christian will turn it off.